We wish to tell you how we think alkaline phosphatase can be used as a therapeutic agent to neurodegenerative diseases like ALS and Parkinson. Our brain is surrounded by an extensive capillary network, blood vessel network, of very small blood vessels in the context of many other cells in the brain that support the neurons to function in the normal context. These supporting cells are astrocytes and glia cells. And glia cells are the immune active cells of the brain, which can be compared very in full with other white blood cells elsewhere in the body. Now, in a normal, healthy system, brain, we see a blood-brain barrier that is totally intact. There are the internal blood cells, blood vessel cells are connected to each other. There is an underlying basal layer, and all kinds of molecules, amongst which alkaline phosphatase, have an intrinsic activity to facilitate transport of neurotrophic components to the brain, of nutrients to the brain, in which, with the ultimate function to serve the neurons to stay healthy. Now, if there is an insult on the brain, we call that an oxidative stress situation, then, and if it is temporary, then these cells are arranging the normal health in the normal stabilization in the brain. They vary from an inactive state M2 state to an active state M1, and the interplay between these two makes that this normal situation is going to be continuous. However, when this insult on the brain, the oxidative stress, is continuous or long-standing, another situation exists. What we see is that the basal lamina is being degraded, and as a consequence thereof, the normal blood vessel cells are extended from each other and white blood cells are inserted into the brain tissue and the brain parenchyma. These are all in M1 state, in an activated white blood cell. Now, these white blood cells further degrade this system and the microglia cells are totally activated. Now, with these activated states, they excrete a lot of inflammatory factors. And these inflammatory factors, like TNF-alpha, IL-1 and IL-6, they make that the neuron, which is normally in an unhealthy state, is now going to be converted into a neuron in stress. That neuron in stress is making molecules like ATP and ADP. And these molecules, they diffuse over the total brain and they further activate these microglia cells, which then convert this system and support this system, this continuous loop, which makes the disease progressive. Now, alkaline phosphatase is going to function as an anti-inflammatory agent. If the insult is too big, then we have to add alkaline phosphatase. Now, what this does is that we see that alkaline phosphatase will diffuse through the holes in the blood-brain barrier, will convert ATP and ADP to a compound called adenosine, which then inactivate these activated cells, both the white blood cells and the microglia cells. If they are inactivated, this loop is not supported anymore. We see that this loop, there are stops on, and there is a continuous fall back into a normal healthy state. So this way will be supported. Now, that means that we go back to an M2 state, a resting state, a supportive state, and we can then, from there on, rebuild, let's say, the total blood-brain barrier. Finally, what we'll see is that the blood-brain barrier is to be restored and normal function is coming back. This is how we think that alkaline phosphatase will function in neurodegenerative diseases as a possible therapeutic agent. This work is carried out by a small company called Amrif. We are located in Wageningen, the Netherlands. We have been founded since 2013. Thank you very much for your attention.